Is flexible dieting the best way to lose weight? Well, I can't answer that for you, but what I will do is I'll give you the pros and cons for this approach. That way you get a better idea if this approach is the best one for you. Now, if you haven't checked out my flexible dieting explained video, then please go see that first, as that video will provide the context for what we're going to get into here today. So let's get right into it. Pro number one of flexible dieting is that you get to continue to eat the foods that you love. You can eat whatever you want, but you just can't eat how much of it that you want. You have to be mindful of your portion sizes and of the overall calories that you take in. That way you know if you're on or off track with the goal that you set for yourself. Eat what you want as long as it fits your macros. Pro number two is that flexible dieting is going to require you to become more and more aware of what you're actually putting into your body. You're going to get a good understanding of the energy content, the calories, and the macronutrients that are contained in the foods and the drinks that you consume. And you're going to learn how to continually adjust what you eat so that you can maintain a level of energy intake that allows you to keep losing weight. All of this is going to require you to be very intentional with what you eat and how much of it that you eat. Pro number three is that you're going to get better at planning and preparing for what you're going to eat throughout the week. As you become more and more accustomed to your calorie targets or to the overall portion sizes that you know you should be eating throughout the day, then you have a better idea of what's to come. A big part of flexible dieting is to budget the amount of calories that you eat. If you know that you're allowed 2,000 calories a day in order to lose weight, then you can plan and prepare accordingly with which foods you want to eat, as well as which trade-offs you're willing to make. Having the foresight into your total calorie budget is going to allow you to plan for social events, the night out, the party during the weekend, the dinner event. You can have days where you're eating higher than normal calories, as long as you're offsetting that with other days during the week where you're eating lower than normal calories. In my opinion, having this ability to plan and prepare is very empowering and is a huge plus for flexible dieting. Pro number four is that you're going to get an intimate understanding and learning of how food is going to affect your body composition. It's going to be abundantly clear why fruits and vegetables are so crucial towards a fat loss diet. It's also going to be abundantly clear why chips, cakes, pizza, burgers are going to be detrimental during a weight loss journey. Once you start tracking the actual numbers, the calories, the macros, you're going to see how those numbers add up, and you're going to see that in relation to your body weight stats. I think being able to see all of these data and all of these numbers and results on paper is really going to crystallize the impact that food has on our body. Tracking calories and macros, even if it's for a short period of time, is just going to provide so much education about nutrition that you wouldn't be able to learn with any other activity. Okay, enough with the good stuff. Let's get into the cons. Number one is that flexible dieting can be easily misinterpreted. The name may suggest that you can eat whatever you want, but as we've already discussed in the previous video, Flexible Dieting Explained, that is not the case. The naming of this approach could have been done better. Personally, I would have called it the Energy Balance Diet or the Calorie Deficit Diet. However, there isn't that sexiness to it. I mean, people aren't going to say I'm on the Energy Balance Diet. They rather say that I'm on the Flexible Diet. It's got more of a ring to it. But if you named it the calorie deficit diet, there's going to be very, very little room for misinterpretation, and therefore, I think it's the better name. Con number two is that counting your calories and tracking your macros is going to take a lot of effort up front initially. Weighing out all of your food, measuring all of your ingredients, logging every meal, every drink that you have, every snack that you have throughout the day is going to wear on most people. It's not a practice that many people can sustain on a long-term basis, and that includes myself. My advice is to dedicate a short time period where you go all in on tracking your calories and macros, and take whatever education that you can out of that experience so that you can better determine what portion sizes are going to be right for you and your goals. If you come out of the experience with better eating behaviors and habits, then that's going to be a major win. Con number three is that some foods are going to be very difficult to track. Typically, these foods contain a lot of ingredients that we don't know about, that they're hidden. Perhaps there's not a nutrition label that's attached to this food. These are foods that you order from restaurants. These are foods that other people prepare for you. You don't know exactly what's being put into it. You don't know exactly what the portion sizes are, and therefore you can't really get a good understanding of its energy content. The more complex a food is, the more ingredients that it has, and also the more highly processed it is, the more difficult it is to track. A best practice for flexible dieting is to prepare most of the foods that you do eat. Eat mostly whole, minimally processed foods, as well as eat foods that contain its own nutrition facts label. That does it for the pros and cons. My overall thoughts on flexible dieting is that it's not really a diet. It's just eating according to scientific principles. This is eating according to physics, according to the law of conservation of energy, according to energy balance. If you have weight loss or body composition goals, then I highly recommend you giving flexible dieting a try. There's no need for you to deprive yourself or to give up on going to family events or social events. All you gotta do is just live out your normal life, but to demonstrate more restraint on the amount of food that you eat. This is an exercise in demonstrating more self-control and self-restraint in the food choices that you make, rather than just an outright restriction and cutting out all of the bad foods that are out there. I'm a big fan of flexible dieting, and if you are too, then let me know in the comments down below. If you have any questions on anything that I discuss in this video, then leave those questions in the comments below as well. If you found value out of this video, if this helped you out, if this got you to take the leap into flexible dieting, then please consider liking this video and also subscribing to my channel for more content just like this. Check out my videos on the next screen, and I will see you in the next one. Peace.